Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Kita sambung lagi ya kuliah kita tadi. Before this we stop at determine the table, which is supposed to be your step one. Of course, at the table there are six column where you kind of like learning a new thing for this chapter four. Is a value of mass multiplied by radius and then the distance. Okay, so more or less we already cover lah. Okay, now we already cover the linear position. Yeah, the linear position is already there. Done. So I'm just going to delete this thing. And then we're going to do a bit of skills, yeah, in order to solve the problem lah, yeah. Okay. Linear position is done. Now we're going to go for couple polygon. Okay, couple polygon, we go by different color scheme. Here, couple polygon. Okay, how you going to draw? First of all, what you have to do is you need to refer your table. So what is your table? On the sixth column, the table is at plane A is negative 1.8. Yeah? 1.8 kilogram meter squared. Okay. So obviously what you have to do, do the scale. Yeah, you know what scale that you're going to take. All right. And then since how do we know? You know, at this point, the first thing first, we need to know what is the direction. Either it's supposed to be on the left, or it take to be on the right. We don't know. Okay. For our case now, why it goes to the left? So we check somehow on our value here for plane A, it goes by negative 1.8 kilogram meter square. Clearly there. So you go by this point to this point with a value of negative 1.8 kilogram meter squared. Of course, it need to comply with this, what you call that, with the scale or the ratio. Then you done on that. Okay. All right. Second part. This dotted line, yeah, how you manage to get it? What you have to do now is you taking your protractor and then using this magnitude, negative 1.62, yeah, this magnitude, and then you're going to comply with the scale that you already set, and then you going to find the titik tengah, the center, the center point. You know, for our case here, yeah. And then you going to draw one big circle. Okay. And then same goes for another value, which is 1.92 at plane D. What you need to do is, at this point, complying with the scale, you're going to draw another big circle. Yeah. So what the point of interest, the point of your interest is the one that connect, you know, intercept towards each other. Yeah. Those intercept to each other. So from there, you know that somehow at this point, yeah, at this line, okay, oh my bad, at this line, at this line, you going to once you manage to get this sort of polygon whatsoever, so you're going to measure using protractor what's supposed to be the angle. Okay, so because it started from here, 1, 2, 3. So from this line, what's supposed to be the angle? Let's say the angle is some, you know, whatever the number, but for our case at point 2, okay, it's a negative. Okay, do not forget, eh? It's a negative, negative 1.62. So since it's negative, so we know that it's supposed to goes down. So if you want to know the angle, you have to add up this one. You're going to plus, you're going to take it like this, up until this point. So if you manage to draw, if you manage to determine what's the supposed to be the angle, what happened after, you're going to draw this one, the angular position. So as we know, in our previous example, they already given all the angles, so easier for you to calculate. But for this case, they don't give you any sort of information in terms of the angles or the position, so you have to find on your own. Okay, yet for this case, A is still a reference. You're going to refer A. So as you can see B now, yeah, in our polygon, it goes like this. Yeah, something like parallel, eh? Okay. So what you have to do, since it's negative, so it supposedly to be in opposite direction. So you're going to measure this angle, or you measure this angle, it's going to be same thing. So it's more like 360 minus with 112, then you got lah your angle. Okay, why I said this angle is very important, because by getting the angle for mass B or whatever masses that you want to find, that you want to calculate, you, it's going to be very useful for you to draw on your first polygon. Okay, so now for our case, we managed to get the angle of mass B. All right, so for our case of mass C, mass D, okay, what is mass D? Mass D, they don't have any negative signage, so whatever the direction is that direction. So if you can see the angle to be this direction, so same goes like this kind of direction. Okay, so to make it clear, and the B1, we know now why it's supposed to be down here, even though at the polygon angle it's supposed to, it draw on top. Why? Because it goes by negative position, negative magnitude. So that's why it opposed in the opposition or in opposite direction. Okay, why for the D case, it's not much different. Okay, since there's no negative sign. Okay, so we are done for the case of angular position, done. However, we still not getting the C direction. Okay. So for the case of C direction, all right, what you have to do is follow me. Yeah. What you have to do is wait up. Okay, now this is some sort of a calculation that you have to kind of know. Since we know the angle mass is zero, okay. So vector C is 0.3 m. Oh, wait up. 0.3 m. So wait up, yeah. Before we start for this case, we're going to draw the first polygon. The first polygon is what? The first polygon is the one that you're going to calculate throughout your MR. Yeah? MR. So for our case now, you're going to use the scale, standard scale, 1 centimeter equivalent to 1.25 kilogram meter. What is your kilogram meter? Is this one, the fourth column. Okay, so A is 1.5 kilogram meter. So, and then it's a positive direction. Yeah, I mean, it's a positive value. So, it's supposed to move in right direction. So, here, sorry, my bad. Therefore, it goes from here to here. 1.2 kilogram meter. Okay. This one is quite straightforward lah, simple. So now you already know what is the distance. Eh? Of course, lah, this one is going to comply with the ratio or the scales that you already set earlier. Eh? Okay. So now A is 1.2 kilogram. Okay, clearly there. So I'm going to delete this one, eh? And then we want to know what is the distance of B, eh? Is 1.8 kilogram meter. So the distance is 1.8 kilogram. My goodness, my bad. The distance is 1.8 kilogram meter. Oh, my bad. Tak cantik. Saya kena lukis lawa-lawa bagi awak faham. This one, 1.8 kilogram meter. This one, 1.8 kilogram meter. Okay, however, we knew that B angle, okay, from here to here, okay, we knew is 112. That's why you got B here. Okay, so now almost done, almost finished. We're going to go from B to D lah. We don't know C. We go by D lah. Okay. D is 2.4. Yeah. D is 2.4. So, we draw lah. is 1, 2. Oh, my bad. My bad. Okay. This one to this one. Okay. So this one is 2.4 kilogram meter. Okay. So what do we know about D? Okay, D is, for this case, is 52. So you go lah by angle 52. Adam lah, bagi lawa-lawa sikit nampak. Angle of 52. So from this point to this point, done. Now your point of interest or your line of interest where you're going to connect at this point to this point. Yeah, the yellow point is the point of interest. Okay, first you want to know what is the distance. D-A-N-C-E, okay, what is the distance? Okay, and then once you know what is the distance, and we know it started from this point, so, okay, you measure from here to here, you measure, you measure what's supposed to be the angle. So somehow you manage to get C to be 123 degrees. This is already given lah. So 123 degrees, and the distance of C is the C is already the distance is 16. Wait up. Color, different color lah, different color much more easier kot, I suppose. Okay, so the distance of C, yeah, the distance of C is 16.96 centimeter, and we know C is also 0.3 mass m. So you just going to equate it, and you manage to get the mass of C. This one, the mass of C is 4.24 kilogram meter. Done. Okay. Okay, and then what is the mass? Not the mass. Sorry. That is MR. Mass multiplied by the radius. So the real mass of C is found to be 14.133 kilogram. And of course, angular. This one, the angular position. You manage to find it lah. Okay. So that's the thing. It's not that difficult, but it's a bit quite tricky and a bit difficult, I know. But if you keep pushing yourself and do lots of question and example, I think you're going to a bit of mahir. Yeah, you're going to be hustler lah. But if you don't do anything, then I think you'll be in great trouble, I suppose. So that's all from me in my class. I hope you enjoying my lecture. Thank you so much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. And bye-bye.